Hello there everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to make this Elvish circlet. And it looks like this. So this is the front of it. And all the way around the side. And then we have the back here. Now on the back I've made some hooks. So what you do is you grab some chain. So this is also adjustable. And you just use those hooks to, obviously you put it on your head. And then the size that you need it to be, you pop the chain on there, and that way this won't open up, so it'll be secure while you're wearing it, but it's also adjustable in size. So that's what it looks like, and that's how it works security wise. And then this is what it looks like up close. So just to show you the design that I've done, so this is basically just a 3-strand braid where I've embellished it along the way, just like this, all the way around. And I've just made both sides symmetrical, as much as you can. The other side as well. But obviously you can choose to make this however you want design-wise, it's completely up to you. I'm just showing the basics of how to do this, or how I've done this. What I'm also going to just do is add some pictures right here, where I've added it onto a head, so you can see how it sits on the head and how it looks as well. So as you can see, all we need to do once we've made the circlet itself is shape it around the head. So if you're making it for yourself, make sure it fits you. And then you have this lovely embellishment going all the way around. And it's nice and secure with the chain at the back. So this is what it looks like. And this is what I'm going to teach you how to do today, how I've made this. So if you want to learn how to do this, then keep watching. So these are the things that we'll need. Now all we need wire-wise is this one gauge of wire. And this is a 0.8mm in thickness, and it's just a regular round wire. And this is all we need throughout the whole piece. We're not doing any weaving with it. And also what we need as well is some chain, because I'm going to use this to kind of use as a closure for the back, and it's also going to be adjustable. And the only thing I will say with the chain, it doesn't matter what kind, but all you need to make sure of is that the links are large enough to take two lengths of your 0.8mm through them. So just make sure of that, so the chain isn't too fine so you can't use it for the closure on the back. So let's get it together and let's get started. So then what we need to do first is cut our wires ready. And what I have here that I'm going to be using is 5 lengths of my 0.8mm wire of about 1 meter each. Now we're not going to be using these wires up equally. So as you go, you might find that you got longer lengths left at the end of some wires than others. But I'd rather have enough of all of them, because it's fairly organic design. You might want to change your mind throughout. So ideally you don't want to run out of wire as you go. So then to start off the piece, we're going to start with one of our lengths of a 0.8mm wire. And what I'm going to do is make the front part first that's going to be centered on the forehead. So what we need to do with this length is put both ends together, just gently, because we need to find the middle of this, because we're going to start working from the middle and then outward towards each side. That also makes it a bit easier because we're just working on one side at a time. So you're kind of technically working with half of the length of the 4 wires. And then we've got the middle point here, roughly. So what I'm going to do is the embellishment right at the front. And for this, I'm just going to be using my 6-step bell making pliers. You can use round nose pliers for this. This is completely fine. But what I'm going to do is choose the size that I want first. And make that little embellishment. So it's my second smallest one. And I want to cross over my 2 wires then. So they're coming to each their own side. And just take your time with this and work gently, because obviously we have a lot of wire to begin with here that we're working with, until we start just working on one side at a time. So this is the beginning part, the very first loop that we made. We're just having wires crossing over at the top. And then what we need to do is make a second one that's a bit larger. To do that, I'm going to then place this in, choose which one I want to use for that. Place my pliers back in. As close as I can get them down. And then all I just want to make sure to have a look at is to see which wires crossed over each other, because now we want to do the opposite. So in this case, the wire coming from the right side crossing over towards the left is the one on top. I want to do the same again. So it kind of intertwines. So get it up as close as possible. So that means the one from the left side that crossed in front before, I take that first, because that now needs to go behind. And cross it over towards the other side. And now take the one from the right side that crossed behind before and cross that in front. It doesn't matter which one you take to the front or which one you take to the back. It's just to make sure you get them intertwined nicely. Remove your pliers, so you're left with this. And there we have the first little design at the front there. So then basically what we need to do now is maneuver the wires a little bit, so the long tails here, just to get them into position and into a nice shape at the front. So I'm going to have them come upwards a little bit with gentle curves in it. I'm always going to have nice and gentle curves, no sharp angles in this one. It's not the kind of design that I'm going for. So have it come upwards a bit, because then what we need to do now as well is add in the rest of our wires and start working on the sides. So then to do that, I take the rest of my wires here, all together, and again put all the ends together just like before, so I find roughly where the middle is of all of them. And then the first part here is kind of the most fiddly part, but just take your time with this. It's a lot easier once we just get this beginning part done. So basically the middle of it, until we start working on the sides. So what I want to do is basically bring all these into it. So just take your time separating them out a little bit, so they lie nicely. And make sure you don't have any kinks or bends in it as well, in any other wires. So I'm going to start working towards one side first. So I'm just going to get all my wires in position here. What I want to do basically is then have all these new wires that I just brought in line up next to the one that's coming out to the first side that I'm going to be working with, and on top of it. So above that embellishment that we made first. And at this point as well, you can just separate them out a little bit, because what I'm going to be making mainly is a 3-strand braid really. We're going to embellish it a bit along the way. So what I want to do is have my 3 sections of braid where in 2 of them I have 2 wires. So the bottom one there, these 2 are going to be 1 section. The next 2 are going to be 1 section. And then the last wire is going to be on its own. So I want to try and just keep hold of it like this. And then what I'm going to do is, what makes it a little bit easier to work with is working with something like a clamp. This is a ring clamp. You can also use a spring clamp or something like that. But I'm going to place all my wires in this, just up here, grabbing the very beginning of the wires, clamp it down, and then just put the peg back in, just like this. Make sure it's nice and tight, because this makes sure this is now holding all your wires. You still want to be careful not moving them too much, but this is now holding all the wires, so it makes it a little bit easier to work with. So now what we can start doing is start making the actual braid. So at this point, once we got the braid started, it's going to be a lot easier. So you just want to basically get your wires in place to begin with, to get into the process of making the braid. So what I want to do is just bring my top one, that's the single wire, just down behind the other 2 sections, just gently. All the moves from now on are going to be quite gentle, and just kind of try and only make curves and not too obvious bends or kinks in it. So just bring it down behind like this, and then we can basically start our 3-strand braid. So this is now the outside one, the top one of the 2 together. That is going to be my first one I'm going to bring over. So I'll keep hold of that best you can. Like I said, the beginning here is always the fiddliest part, and you kind of got the clamp a bit in the way, but we'll manage. So what I always like to do when I make my braids is, instead of just taking the section and taking it over, I like to just put my fingers where I want that kind of bend or the curve to be, because it makes it a really nice and gentle curve. So keep hold of that. So I'm going to show you the best I can. Keep hold of your wires up here. It's going to be easier once we get further down. And then keep hold of where you want them to cross over with your fingers. And gently start moving these across and into the middle. So like a regular 3-strand braid. So right now we're just making the first one here. It's a regular one without any embellishment. We're going to start with that with the next one. So as you can see, it's still loose, but it's going to get better as we go. So we now brought the first section over and into the middle. So now what we want to do is take the next section here. So this is a single wire. If For this, I want to add some embellishment to this. Now, this is kind of the same thing that I'm going to be doing throughout. What I like to do is just make sure it sits in place as good as you can. And I like to smooth it out and gently get a curve in there, because what I'm going to do is start bending this around. So take the end of your wire and basically just using your hands and your fingers, you can make a little curl right here, taking your time, making it nice and rounded and curvy. Just making it as small or as large as you want it to be by pulling it into the shape that you want. And also what you can do is, you can do this with your fingers most of the time. What you might need to do sometimes is grab some round nose pliers, for instance, and then that can help you if you want to, say, make it smaller. Like this one, I want to be smaller because it's right at the front. So just grab into it and enforce it smaller as well. So that can help you make it smaller until you're happy with how it looks. Now that's quite a nice size there. And then naturally now, the tail, the long tail of this wire is coming over that section that we just brought over in the first place. So that's happening naturally, and then in towards the middle there. So that's where the 3-strand braid as well is being made. So that's that section. So to then take that last section that we haven't moved yet, then what I'm just going to do is make sure everything is in place, because obviously this is still loose. We haven't really done enough of the braid yet for it to hold itself. So just make sure it sits how you want it to sit. So like that, and then keep hold of it all with your fingers, and right where you want that angle, or not the angle, but the curve to be, then take these two together, bring them over and into the middle. Just like that. So we're crossing over the single wire now. And there we've used all of them. And as you can see, we're just doing a 3-strand braid with our sections of wires here. And don't worry too much about, say, the angle that you're going at, because you will most likely naturally become coming at a bit of an angle from that center point. But also it's something we can correct towards the end, so don't worry too much about that. And then still continuing with the braid, so taking the next section, you can always kind of see which one you're due to use. It's the one that's the furthest down that hasn't crossed over yet. So again, place your wires. It's still a bit loose, we are getting there. Take that section, bring it over to both wires together, over that other section with both wires, and into the middle. So you get that nice curve, just like this. Always making sure to keep your wires separate. So there we go. That's the beginning so far. And then now we reach the point where we have the single wire again. And it's mostly this one that I'm going to be using to add embellishments as we go. You can also use the eyes, but the other wires there, but I'll be showing that later on. So for this case, again, I want to have some embellishment before I bring this over. So I'm going to technically just do the same thing. Start out with having them placed, the wires where I want them to sit, and then get a nice and gentle curve there to begin with. Like that, then take the end of the wire, bring it back on itself, so like this. Like I said, most of the time you can just do this with your fingers. You'll probably find natural rhythm as well. And just bring it down, make it smaller. Make it how ever small or large you want this curl to be. This one I want to be a little bit bigger than the last one, because we're moving further towards the side. So right at the front there, I wanted them to be small because I wanted the main embellishment to be that center point. But then I'm making them a slightly larger as we're moving out towards the sides. So something a bit like this. And then just smooth out the rest of it here if you've curled it up a bit. Just making sure that all your wires are always nice and smooth. And obviously curves are fine, but not any obvious kinks or bends. And if you have any, if you see any, always make sure to sort them out before you move on, because you can't really, it's going to be too difficult to do after. So like that. Now again, because we've done that curl, this naturally crosses over that section and into the middle. So we'll move on to the next one. Obviously we're working with long wires, but just take your time doing this and just make sure you get space around you. But also the more we get done, the shorter the wires will be, so it'll become easier. But as you can sort of start to see there, the braid is really forming now. And then with this one, we've now reached the other one on this side, because you can see that's the one furthest down that hasn't been used. Take both of those together. Keep hold of where you want your curve to be and bring them both at the same time over that single wire and into the middle. And just keep maneuvering your wires until they sit how you want them to sit. So remember, you control the wire. Make nice and gentle curves so it looks nice and organic all the way throughout. So that's now that part. Again, to continue the braid, now take the top ones here, keep those together, put your fingers to keep hold, and then there, put your curve in there, cross it over into the middle, and there we go. So we're now starting to really be able to see we're building that braid up, and this has become a lot more secure now as well, and easier to work with, because first of all we have more space, but also the braid is starting to really hold itself. So at this point, now you can tell that the braid is starting to hold itself nicely. You can choose whether you want to keep working with the clamp, or maybe it would be easier to take it off. It's completely up to you. I'm just going to take it off for the purpose of making it a bit easier to show. So now we're at this point where it's a single wire that we need to work with. And because we're now working our way further towards the side, I want to start adding a bit more embellishment to it as well. So in the center we have this embellishment, and I just have these single ones because I want that to be the main focus in the center. Now because we're working towards the sides more, what I want to add is a few more curls here per time that we're using this. So for instance, in this one I want to make two instead of just one like I've done in the others. So what I'm going to do is just get into position to make it easy to work with. And then just like before, I'm going to bring the long end of my single wire there around over itself. And then just spend time on getting this first curl that I'm making exactly how I want it to be. And just like I said, you can most likely use your hands and fingers. If not, just use some tools as well, that's fine. Like say round nose pliers or bail making pliers will help as well. So this one I want it to be still a bit smaller because we need to fit more of the curls in. And just maneuver it in place, so something like this, a little bit smaller, so I can always take my pliers and help with that. Until I'm happy. So something a bit like this. But then instead of just going straight over now, I want to make another one. So do the same thing again, get the long end of your wire, take it back on itself to get that shape of your curl in there. And just take your time maneuvering this until it sits just how you want it to sit. And you see I'm fitting in two there now, before we only did one. I'm adding in a bit more detail. And again, make it as large or as small as you want it to be. Now what I like to do is when I'm adding in more than one, I like to kind of graduate them. So make the smallest one first, and then the largest one if I'm doing two. If I'm doing three, smallest, medium, and the largest. Obviously that's completely up to you, that's just what I prefer. And now that we have that, then it's the same principle where the long end now is naturally crossing over into the middle. So we just stick with that. And then just keep making the braid. So now take the top one, keep hold of your wires as you're crossing them over, both of them at the same time, and into the middle. So something like this. And there you can really start to see the braid forming with the added embellishment as we go with that single wire. That's why I wanted one of the sections to be just a single wire, to purposely kind of use it for that. So this is the really the basics of how to make this. It's quite simple, you just need to take your time doing it. And pretty much you can design it as you go as well. So like I said, for some I'm going to do one curl, for some I'm going to do two, and some I'm going to do three. So you want to keep doing this, design it however you want. I'm going to do a bit more now, do a bit more of a section, and then show you how it looks when I've gotten a bit further. So I've now made a bit more of a section here. So you can see I started out with the single ones, then moved to two, and then I've moved on to three now. And I've just done a single one here, but it's like I said, you can just design this as you go. So there's no set way really. You can do the same as me, but you can also just... It's about also looking at proportion and see what you think looks nice and where you want your embellishment to be. So now that I'm here, what I also want to show you is how to do some embellishment with these double sections where we have two wires in. Because obviously if we're only doing it with this single wire, which is also why I made him long enough to begin with, if you just want to do it with a single wire, that's fine. But you want to make sure, because obviously this is getting used up a lot more along the way than the other ones, because this one we're using to make the curls with. So, in case, say, you've not had enough, you didn't cut enough to begin with, and you kind of feel like you might not have enough to finish it, you'll be running out, what you can do is start making some embellishment with these sections as well, or just do it by choice. So what I'm going to do is, again, grab the section where I want to curve it, bring it over to begin with, just like the other times, get a nice curve in there. And then, before I move on, I want to add the embellishment into here. So in this case, I just want to put a single curl with this section. So what I'm going to do is just separate the wires out and just take the one that's towards the outside. So in that case, that's this one. And remember, I've already kind of put them into position, so I already have the curve in there. So I'm just going to take a bit of time and gently, again, do the exact same thing. Bring this wire around and back on itself to get a nice curl in there, and then just basically place it exactly where you want it to sit. So you can just move your piece around as well, make it most comfortable for you to work with, and just use your fingers and pull that curl down. So when your wire crosses over itself right there, basically it's going to come into the same path that it was on before. So when you bring it back in with the other one, it's going to lie in the same position above the other one. So these two wires in each section, they never cross over each other. You can just choose to make embellishment with them, with the one that's on the outside. So obviously if this section is on the bottom of the braid, it'll be the other wire that we're going to use. And then make sure to bring them all the way in again with that section together. And there you can see you have that little curl in that section with two wires in. So you can quite easily do that as well. And just continue with your braid. Bring the other one, the next one, over and into the middle. Like that. And then you can also use a single wire just as part of the braid. You don't have to do embellishments with this. It's nice having a bit of different texture in there as well. So making sure that that's in place. And then just, again, place your fingers and bring this over. So you get a nice and gentle curve. There we go, you can see. Get a really nice effect and look from that. And now again with this one, bring it over into the middle. And as you can see, this is the section we just did a curl with there, the double section. So you can do the same thing with this. And this is where you can see I'm now using the same section but the opposite wire, because that's the one that's on the outside of the braid now, on the underside here. So you have the curve in place, and take your wire here, bring the long end around and back on itself, and then get that nice little curve, curl, teardrop shape in there. So say for this one, for instance, I would want to do two. So make sure the first one is quite small. So that's the smallest one, so the graduate, but also so I have space to put in another one. Go around again. Long tail around itself. And gently maneuver your wire in place. So just take your time here. Work with the curves of your wire. And make nice and gentle movements until it sits how you want it to sit. And then again the tail here, go back in its original path, so lie on the outside of the other wire. You have something that looks a bit like this. And those two are now in the middle. And then you just continue the braid. So I've kept making some more braid here with embellishments as well. Now what I don't want to do is just finish off these wires straight away, because you obviously need to know how long you need this piece to be. This is only going to be in one half, around one half of the head. So what I'm going to do is move back to the middle again, and before I do anything more on the other side, so I also don't want to make too much obviously because that's going to be an issue, then I want to start making the other side as well. Now what you can do is obviously make this completely random from each other. Personally, I like to keep them as similar as I can. So when I make this side, I keep referring back to this one. So for instance, I make sure it's in the right places to make the same amount of loops there. But that's completely up to you. It's just personal preference. You can also make it organic. So what I'm going to do is we just need to sort all the wires out right at the front here. So I can see already that the angle is going to be a bit off. But like I said, it's not too big of a deal. We can still work with that. Also at the end correct that if we need to. But what I've got now is my sections of wires here. I've got the two sections with two wires in. I need to keep them together and just sort it all in place. I want to make sure that this wire, where I have two in the section, but the one that's above the first piece of embellishment that I made, that basically runs along the same curve right above that towards the other side. So it's going to sit roughly something like that, running just along the top of that. And then it's going to come towards the top, these two wires, because we're still going to be working with the same sections. So that's going to be coming towards the top there. And obviously once we make the braid on the other side, that's going to keep these in place as well. But we need to get to that point first. Then what I have left is the other section of two, and then the section where I just have the one wire. So what I also want to do is a bit more embellishment right in the middle there with just the one wire, because that's going to basically be at the very top. So I already have this other section of twos kind of sweeping across nicely above the other wires right there and coming down a little bit, so lying kind of give it the same angle as these, or the same curve, and swooping up again towards the other side. And like I said, just keep taking your time with this to get it right, and you can always keep correcting it. So I now have that. So this single wire is coming towards the top of the middle there. So what I want to do with that is just add some embellishment right at the top and try and make sure that I have it in the middle. So it's coming from the side with that very first curl that we did. Make sure it's nice and free of any kinks, and then try and hold this in place as much as you can. Then what I'm going to do is again make another curl right at the top in the middle. So basically if you're looking at the front there, right above this, so if it's almost like you're making a head for the body, if you can call it that, the exact same way, bring it around back on itself. Out to the other side, and then you just want to take a bit of time here and work with it to make sure it's going to sit and have the shape and size that you want, but also going to sit right there in the middle. So just take your time doing this. Again, some pliers can maybe help with this. So if you've got a side that's a little bit straight, you can help give it a curve again by using some pliers without having to change the positioning. So almost something a bit like this. You can see it's going to sit nice and straight across the middle on top of these. And then the other wires are going to be swooping across there in the section sat pretty much just like this. So that single wire is basically sat behind the other two. So then once we have the wires in place, we have the clamp on if you want to use that, then I have my single wire there coming down behind the others, just like on the other side. I want to take the top pair, the top section there with two wires, and just bring that into the middle. It's going to be the very beginning of our braid here. This is something as well, as I go, I keep smoothing out my wires. It warms them up so it's easier to work with. But also, you're getting out any kinks or bends, because as you're working with this and creating your curls and your features and that, you will be getting that further down on the wire. So just keep straightening out, running your hands over them, your fingers, and it warms them up as well, so it becomes easier to work with. So just like this. And then we're just going to keep... we're just going to start off with a braid again, basically. So, the very furthest down, that's not been used yet. So, this is the single one in my case. What I need to do, remember we put that little curl on the other side. So we need to do that here as well, the single one. So just take your time, bring this back on itself. And get your curl in there. And then what I like to try and do is get it roughly the same size, as close as I can. And also because this is the front, I want this to be as symmetrical as possible. So what you might need to do, because obviously the clamp is a little bit in the way from being able to see, so I might need to just take that off to make sure I place this curl in the right place compared to the other side there. See, that's actually a bit too close to the middle. So you can just undo it a little bit, because that's the thing, it's curls that we're making. So it's not like you put a sharp bend in there with your pliers, but it's much easier to undo if you're not quite happy. So undo this a little bit, and easier than to straighten that as well. So as I said, you can straighten it out and redo it if it's not quite in the right place. Obviously over here, you're just making it as you go. On this side, if you want to try and keep it symmetrical, like what I want to do, so symmetrical to each other, then you might just have to do that once or twice. But it will get easier once you get past that first stage here. Bring it further out to the side. Something a bit more like this. Again, if you need to, you can always bring in some pliers, just using some round nose pliers to help make this smaller. And curl it around. So this definitely looks better in position. Just need to make it a bit smaller, something like this. And there we go. And then it's just a matter of basically starting the braid up again. So I've now kept working on this side until I've reached the same point as I did on the other side. So now both sides are even, and I've also made sure they're as even as possible with the embellishment. So they're pretty much the same length now from the middle there. And you can see we are slowly, naturally getting a bit of that shape that we need. But obviously we're going to adjust that at the end as well. So now what we can do is go back and decide what to do now. So first thing to do is maybe measure it against your head, or just measure it depending if you know how long you want it to be, because obviously we need these two to go around each side of the head and then almost meet at the back. So not completely meet up, because that's what we're going to use a chain for. But then what we're also going to need to do now is, what I like to do, because obviously we need to finish off our wires as well, I like to kind of finish them off a little bit as we go, at least a couple of them, so we don't end up with five wires right at the end. So if we only have a few less wires than that, it makes it a little bit easier to finish off. So for that, what I'm going to do is, doesn't matter what side you do this on, start from, because if you'll be doing the same thing, I'm just going to continue my braid here. And now, this is around kind of the main, the side, obviously this is the front and then around the side of the head. Towards the back, I like to kind of make my embellishment a bit less again, so graduate to less and less, and down to maybe only one, and just not every time either, evenly throughout. So just do it a few times as we move further towards the back. So I might do more braid now with just the wires, without doing embellishment every time like I did before. But that's obviously, again, completely up to you and design-wise. That's why I also said to start with fairly long wires. It's mainly for that reason, so you have that choice to design that as you go. Because if you want all the embellishment all the way back to the same degree as this, you're going to need to use more wire than if you don't want as much. So it's completely up to you. But I'm going to keep with the braid until I reach a point. Here I want to finish off one of my wires. Now how I'm going to do that is I'm going to finish off one out of the section where I have two wires in the same section. So I want to do the bottom ones there, so I just need to get to that point and continue the braid, because we also want to obviously finish them off so they're nice and secure, so ideally not going to catch on anything or scratch on anything, but also so they blend in nicely and it's not too obvious. So what I'm going to do is, again, bring this up over towards the middle. Just continue that braid. And then I'm just going to start out making another curl here, just as I've been doing all the other places. So again, this is then using this section that I just put a curve on, using the wire out of those two that's furthest, that's on the outside of the braid basically. And then I want to just take my time, make a little curl here, take the wire back on itself and gently shape it just like that. And I prefer to make them not too big, because the bigger, the more fragile that curl is going to be, especially because this is going to be finishing off a wire. Now there's no reason to bring this back out, because what I'm going to do then is grab my cutters. So I'm using these. So these are just some flush cutters. It gives a much neater finish instead of just regular cutters. Obviously you can use regular cutters if you have them and not these. So what I'm going to do basically, finish this curl off, this little circle, and I'm going to cut off the tail right where my wires overlap basically. So the excess that's coming out. So I want to cut off the excess of that just where now, if you push it down, the end of that wire is basically going to run right into itself. And then I'm going to take some flat nose or chain nose pliers, because right now it's still sticking out, and I'm just going to make sure to basically squeeze this together. So exactly that very end of the wire basically just buds right up against itself, so that kind of gets rid of that end, but at the same time it's quite seamless because it's just another curl just like the rest of them, so it blends in nicely. So that's how we got rid of one wire. So now we're down to still our three sections to obviously make the braid, but now we have two sections where we just have one wire, so that's also going to make the braid kind of look a bit smaller towards the back. And then I'm just going to keep braiding still. And you can get rid of another wire if you want to, a bit further towards the back. You want to also be aware, obviously, that you still need the strength in the braid. So you might need to keep this last section of two until you reach almost all the way to the back. So I've now reached the point where this is the full length of my one side. And I've also done the equivalent to the other side there. So what you can basically just do is count the loops if you want to make sure you get to the same place. So far, this is where we're at. Obviously, it's not 100% in shape either. So now what I'm going to do is focus on finishing off my wires here. I'm not going to shape it until after that, just because we might put it out of shape while we're finishing off the wires here. So what we need to do is look at all the wires we have. Now obviously we have four left because we already got rid of one. So what I'm going to do is just work with one wire at a time here. I'm just going to start with my single ones. These two I'm going to use to also then be able to make that hook on the back. So I'm just going to leave these two till the end. So I'm going to start with my top single one and just do the same thing. Make a nice loop, bring it back on itself. And again, because we're finishing it off, I don't want this loop to be too big. Again, you can always use your pliers to get it just the right shape that you want. And then take your cutters again to go in and cut off the excess. Just cut it off right where it's going to meet itself. Just like that. And then take your flat nose or chain nose, bring it around the back if you need to. And then what I like to do is, where I finish off that wire, first of all it's butting up against itself again, but I also like to just tuck it in behind the wire that's kind of crossing in front when creating the braid. And you can just make sure that you also can't feel it on the back, because you don't want it to catch on your hair obviously. So that's that one. Now I'm going to do the other single wire down here. Again, just take that back on itself. Also make that quite small. Just like that. Take my cutters and cut that off. And again, kind of flatten it down there. So the very tail, the end of the wire, isn't exposed. And you can always just gently tuck it in behind those two wires lying next to each other. So that's another two wires finished off. So now I just have these two left. So this is, like I said, what I also want to use to make the hook. The little kind of loop shape we're going to attach the chain to. So right now they're coming up at an angle from the braid. What I want to just do is I'm going to separate them out because I'm only going to use one to make that hook. I just want to kind of have that coming out straight. So just gently do that so it looks nice still, and have it come straight out like it continues from the braid. So like that. And then this is the one I'm going to use to make that little hook with. So then firstly, before I make the hook, I just want to get rid of the other one here. So what I'm going to do with this is, if you look on the braid, we have a little gap right there at the end. What I'm going to actually do is take the end of this wire and come up through there. So it's basically going to be looping around one of the other ones. So the one down here that we already finished off. And just gently pull that through. And just do this gently because it's obviously the same gauge wire. We don't want to pull anything out of shape. It's just to also kind of bind the end together here. And you can always use some flat nose to help you press it around that wire so it basically becomes nice and tight around it. You don't want it to be open or anything. Just like that. And now what you can do is go around this another time for the extra security, assuming you've got the space. So just pull it up through and gently guide it through there. So just like that. And then, like I said, just squeeze it to make sure it's not too bulky as well. So just like that. And then I'm going to take my cutters and cut this excess of the tail off. And what I want to do is just cut it off towards the inside there, because then the tail, the end of the wire, is basically tucked away in there and not pointing towards your head or not pointing towards the outside. And then just take my flat nose again and squeeze that end nice and tight. and run your fingers over it to make sure you can't feel anything. Then on the other side, what we have left now is this single wire that we're going to use to make the hook with. Just use your pliers, straighten it out, get a nice angle in there. And then we need to make sure this is as straight as possible, because then we need to go out a couple of centimeters or so. It really depends how large you want your hook to be as well. Place your pliers, your flat nose or chain nose, and then bend this around completely back on itself, just like that. And then we need to squeeze this tight. As tight as you can. Just do it gently. It's going to help make the hook a lot stronger as well. Using these two wires, well, the same one, but having them lying right next to each other. Just like that, and make sure that the tail comes straight down next to itself. And straighten the hook out if you need to. So there we go. Now what we need to do is just secure this in place. So I'm going to grab hold of this, these two wires. And then what I want to do is bring the tail up and just be able to wrap this around a couple of times. So base it around itself to begin with to secure this in place. Just a couple of times like that. And again, all the way down towards the bottom there. So we don't have any too much bare wire exposed, just single wire there. And what you can also do is just wrap it around that loop that we made to finish off one of the other wires. It just gives it a bit extra security and kind of binds the whole end together as well. And then you just want to get your cutters again. When you're happy with how it sits, cut the excess off and tuck that into place. Just like every other end of your wire, make sure to always tuck it in. Especially if this is something that's going to be in your hair. So there we go. Run your finger over it again, make sure you can't feel it. Now all that's left to do is shape the actual hook here. So I'm going to use my bail making pliers. You can use round nose pliers if you want. And just start, go from the very end and start looping this back. So it looks a little something like that. You just get a little hook shape there. And this is all we're going to use to hook into the chain. Because obviously once it's on your head, we have that chain to stop these two sides from opening up. The chain is going to hold them together, which is going to make it nice and secure around your head. So that's how I'm going to finish all this off. And also again, it blends in nicely because you've got some loops there. And you want to just do exactly the same thing on the other side, obviously. Get rid of those wires so you have a hook on each side. And then all that's left to do after that is shape it. So I've now finished off both ends there and I have my loop, one on each side. So all that's left to do now really is shape this into the shape that we need. So what I'm going to do is start from the front and just gently start to put a nice, more of a curve in there, because obviously this needs to follow the shape of your head around the sides. And just do this gently a bit at a time. This obviously needs to sit a little bit down in your forehead while these come a bit up the side and then all the way around towards the back. You can also put it against your head and help that way shape it. We just put some nice and gentle curves in there, a bit at a time, gradually. So, if we look at this, the head, how it's going to sit. Obviously, this is going to be right at the front there. So I can see these still need to come down towards the side. So just make sure to do this. And you can also adjust if you need to push anything out or push it in. So any of these you can push in or pull out a little bit. Obviously you don't want one of these to sit and digging into your skin or something. So you can also do that along the way. So just want to keep shaping this. So then once you're happy with the shape, As you can see, the wire is strong enough in itself because we use multiple lengths of that 0.8mm to hold its shape. Now, it's not going to stay in shape on your head like this because we have this opening. So what we will need to do is use our chain for that. So what I would say to do is you can put it on your head, and on the back here, these two loops that you have, hooks, what you do is just simply put one part of the chain through that, and the other side, obviously, because you'll then know on your head what you need to, what distance you need to have in between, because you need to have a bit of tension there so it stays in kind of the right size that you need for your head, and then this won't pull apart, so be able to fold down or open up, and that's how you then fasten it, and then that way it's also adjustable. So that's how I'm going to finish off the ends there, and using the chain so it makes it easy to wear and also for different sizes and shapes of heads. So this is how it looks. So pretty simple and elegant design. Just making that braid as we go, adding the embellishment in. And like I said, you can do that however you want to. So it looks like that. A nice little feature there on the front. So I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and that you found it useful as well to make your own of these if you want to. But otherwise, then thank you very much for watching. Hello there, everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to make this elvish ear cuff. And this is what it looks like. So this is the design that I've chosen to do. And what you have is, you have this bare wire coming around the back of your ear that sits around the back. And then this comes around the bottom below your earlobe and then back up on the other side. And then this down on the other side of your ear in front. And then this